Creating a website had never been so easy. In this video, I'll show you how anyone and everyone can create a professional looking website using WordPress and DB theme. But before starting, let's first have a look at two things. First, the website which we are going to create, and second, how powerful the DB theme is. So this is the website which we will be creating in this video. As you can see, it is very beautiful, well crafted website, very professionally made. The first, we have a full width slider with the background in image. Then we have a heading, a subtitle, and a call to action button. We can also add a video in the background. For example, I have shown, as you can see, there is again a header, a subheader, and a video in the background. And as you can see, it really plays very well. So this is our first section. This website is actually divided into many different sections. And a very cool thing about this website is that it's both a single page website and a multiple page website. Let me show you what I mean by that. So let's move on. Let's see the second section. So this is our second section, the services section, a must have section for all kind of websites. We have three services over here, and the beautiful images and videos which I have used in this video can be found in a link which is given in the video description below. So you can also use these images which I have used in the video and in the website obviously. And in the third section, we have about us section, some text at the left hand side, an image on the right hand side, and a very beautiful background image. And as I said, you can download these images from the link which is given in the video description below. Now moving on to the next section, which is our member section, or you can call it our team section. Again, we have maintained the size of the heading as 40 pixels and the size of the subheading as 16 pixels, which gives you a very constant look throughout the website. And we have three members over there. This is their designation and a very short description about themselves and some social links. Then our next section is the our mission section. Again, we have a very beautiful progress bar at the right side and some text at the left side. We also have a testimonial section. So basically, we have crafted this website looking at the needs which all the website require, like the testimonial, the gallery, the blog, the our member section, the services, the about us section. So all you'll find almost everything which you need for your website. So let's move on. This is the gallery section. You can also see there's a very beautiful transition and animation when we scroll down when the next section appears. So it really looks beautiful. Then we have our latest post section. We all know the importance of blogs and posts today. All the great websites, all the giant corporations have a blog section, a different blog section. So whenever these blogs will be updated, it will be updated over here also on the main homepage. Then we have a map, which is a part of contact us section. And at the bottom, we have a footer stating the address, phone numbers, email address, and timing. So this is basically our homepage. But as I said, it is a single page website and also a multi-page website. Let me show you what a single page website means. For example, as you can see over here, we have our menu bar. So when we click on about us, as you can see, we are redirected on the same page to a different section, which is the about us section. Then when we click on our members, we'll be sent to the our member section. Similarly, when clicked on testimonials and blog, we'll be sent to different sections. But many people, they say, we want different pages for different sections or different purposes. So for them also, we have done something. For example, as you can see, we have created different pages also. For example, suppose you don't want this kind of contact us section and you want altogether a different page for contact us. So you can also do that. Let me show you how the contact us page looks like. So let's click on this contact us page. Now this is altogether a different contact us page. As you can see, a map with a marker. When we click on the marker, we get to know the address. Then at bottom, we have another section. At the left side, there is a contact us form with a captcha option. And at the right side, we have some basic information, the address, phone number, and business hour of the business. And obviously the footer is constant throughout the video. We have another page, the portfolio page, which is also a very important page for all the businesses, almost all kind of businesses. As you can see, the portfolio page is also very appealing, very professionally crafted. Now, very useful images are being used. And remember one thing, the images which you use in the video or in the website is really, really important. You know, images are almost everything in the video. The more beautiful and more professional image you have on the website, the more better your website will look. Now let's see the About Us section or About Us page, which is obviously a very, very important page, a must-have page for all kind of website. We all want to, you know, tell the audience about ourselves, about our website, about our company, how we started. So this is our About Us page, a background, as you can see. Headline, subheadline, call to action button. It's all up to you whether you want or you don't want this. Then we have some icons with some text. Then again, our story, you can write in your story. These are all dummy text over here. You can replace it with your own text. Then again, we have a progress bar. Then we have a members section. And if you would have noticed, we have kept the color very consistent, as you can see, throughout the website, so that it gives a very, you know, cool look. But I also said you that it is a very powerful theme with so many features, and creating a website which, you know, with Divi theme is maybe the most easiest thing to do in the world. Let me show you how. Just click on over here, enable visual builder. And now suppose I want to change the text over here, create a website with WordPress. So I just make the changes, so I don't have to go to the back end or do any kind of coding or something. I just select it, type in any other text I want. So this is so easy. And suppose I want this image over here and this image over here, so I can do that also. Just some drag and drop, really easy stuff. You know, just drag this image over here and drag this image over here. So it is that easy. And also changing the title is very easy, as you can see. So it is really easy, really cool, and it's always a fun working with Divi theme. So this was a very short example of how powerful and useful this theme is, and I hope you guys really like the website, the demo website, and you guys are also excited just like me to go ahead and make this website. If so, then stay tuned. To create any kind of website, whether it be a social network site, e-commerce website, a business website, any kind of website, we need two basic things: a domain name and a hosting account. And actually, there are many different providers for domain and both hosting accounts. You can do your own research. I basically follow the HostGator because I am using HostGator for last 5 years or maybe more than that. So I basically believe those guys and have faith in those guys. They are really good. They are really professional, their service is really great. If you like some other service provider, obviously you can go ahead with that. I have no problem with that. But if you want to follow me, and if you are also interested in HostGator, then what you can do is open a new tab, type in blogdude.com/HostGator. If you want some more discount, then go ahead and, you know, go to this link, blogdude.com/HostGator. You will be redirected to the shared hosting page. And HostGator has basically three different plans: the Hatchling plan, Baby plan, and Business plan. I always prefer the Baby plan. If you are, you know, if you have seen my different tutorials, then I always go with the Baby plan, because, you know, you have unlimited domains option in the Baby plan, whereas you don't have that option in the Hatchling plan. And Business plan is basically, we don't need that. You know, we are happy and satisfied with the Baby plan. We need whatever we need, whatever our requirements are, is fulfilled by the Baby plan. So we basically don't need the Business plan. So go ahead and click on sign up now. Okay, so this is the checkout page. First, you have to enter your domain name, whatever domain name you want. For example, I obviously will want blogdude.com, but that is already taken because I already own this domain. So if that is the case, then what you do is click on I already own this domain. If you already have a domain, then you do this, and you get many different options, many different, you know, options given you by HostGator, blog2.club, blog2.site, .net. I'm happy with .com. Go ahead and select your own domain. The package type is already selected as baby. You can change from here also, but stay tuned with baby. That is really awesome. You can change the billing cycle. By default, it is 36 months. You can go with 12 months. That is more, you know, suitable for anyone. You can choose any username. For example, let's choose Nayesh777. And you can choose any security pin. It must be 4 to 8 characters long and it should contain only numbers. So just select any 4 numbers and fill in your billing information, your email address, first name, last name, company name, all the basic informations, obviously. Then you have to put in the credit card or debit card, ATM card, you know, information over here, the card through which you want to make payment. You can also pay with PayPal. It's all up to you, whatever you prefer. Then we have some additional services. Just deselect all which is already selected because we don't need that basically. Then we have a coupon code, and what you have to do is just select everything, press the delete key and put in webdude45 and click on validate. Basically what this does is it gives you a greater discount by using this coupon code. So if you want a greater discount, you can use this coupon code. After you do this, just click on over here, I have read and agree to the terms of services, and click on checkout now. After you do so, you should receive an email from HostGator. Let's see this email. Okay, so this email is actually very important. It has many different and important informations and links related to your website, related to the security of your website. So first, what you have to do is open the control panel link in a new tab and copy and paste your username and password from here and click on login. Basically, there are many different options and many different features in this cPanel, but we are going with the WordPress one-click installation because now we have to install WordPress on our domain name or on our website. So just click on WordPress one-click installation. Now from here, select your domain name which you have just registered. Okay, I have so many different domain names. This is the one, dv3.blog2.com, and make sure the directory thing is empty, you don't put anything over here, and click on next. Now you can put in any blog title if you want, and obviously this can be changed further, so it's not, you know, necessary that you have to think very systematically and you have to put some really title and good title and you cannot change it further. It's not that. You can put in any title which can be changed further. Put in any admin username. Okay, you can put in anything, your first name, your last name, your email address. Make sure the email address is active, you have access to that email address, because you know, if in future anything happens to your account, then you will be informed through this particular email address. So make sure it is, you know, active email address and through which you have access. After you do so, click on install now. Okay, now it says installation is complete. You have your username and a very creepy password. First, now let's open this link in a new tab. It says website coming soon. Now what we have to do is copy and paste the username and password. So let's copy the password. And after your domain name, you have to put /wp-admin and press enter. So this is our login page. Now put in your username and paste in your password which you got from here and click on login. Okay, so this is our WordPress dashboard, the, you know, control panel or the backend of WordPress website. So first just click on here. I don't need any help because I'm there to help you, don't worry. So you can surely click on that. After doing so, the first thing, whether you install WordPress now, in future, one website or 100 websites, the first thing you're gonna do is hover here and click on edit my profile. And now we have to change the password because, you know, we got a really creepy password, really difficult to remember password from HostGator, obviously because of some security purposes, but you know, we want our own password that we can easily remember. So you can click on generate password and put in your own password. It can be anything. Don't put these kind of password, obviously, but just for the sake of demonstration, I have put this password. After you do so, tick mark confirm use of weak password and click on update profile. Okay, a newer version of WordPress is available. So whenever you see this message, just click on please update now and always be updated. Use the latest WordPress website or WordPress platform. Okay, fine. Click on update now. Now click on dashboard over here. Now we see this message. Your site is currently displaying a coming soon page. Once you're ready to launch your website, click here. So once you're ready to launch your website, after completing this whole tutorial, you can click on over here. But now for the sake of demonstration, because I'll always have to show you the website, so I click on over here. So after doing so, let's see how our website looks like now. So hover over here and you'll see visit site. Just open this link in a new tab. So this is how our website looks right now. As you can see, it is not at all appealing, not at all beautiful or professional. It doesn't look professional from any angle, obviously. And we have to create something amazing, something awesome, something really, really like this. So for that, we need something called a theme. Obviously, the title is create a website with DV theme. So we will use DV theme for this particular tutorial. So for that also, what you can do is just put in blogtube.com/DV in your URL bar and click on enter. Okay. And now you get this option, join to download. So click on join to download. And there are two packages, the yearly access package and the lifetime package. So it's all up to you, whatever you want. You yearly have to pay $90 and for lifetime you have to pay just $250 and you'll have lifetime access to all themes, to all plugins, lifetime updates. And in yearly access, I have to clear one misconception. Many people think that every year you have to compulsorily pay. No, it's not that. Suppose now we have DV 3.0 and next year if DV 3.5 or 4.0 comes out, then if I want that version, then I have to pay. But if I'm happy with 3.0, then I don't have to pay. I can use it for more than 1 year, for 2 years, for 5 years, any number of years you want. And a very good thing, very great thing about this theme is, you can use this particular theme on n number of websites. It's not that it can be used on only website. It's not that you can use on multiple websites. So it is really cool. So select your package, yearly package, lifetime access. I basically prefer the sign up for lifetime access, but it's all up to you. It's a one-time fee. I don't have to pay it again and again, and it's really cool to go with lifetime access. So click on sign up today and fill the form and go ahead and download the theme. So once you download the theme, let me show you how it will look like. This is the DV theme. Okay, this is how your theme should look like. It's around 6.8 megabytes. Okay, now to convert this dummy and really boring website into amazing like this, we have to install this theme, the DV theme, on our website. So for that, come back to your dashboard, click on appearances, and after that click on upload, because we have the file and now we have to upload this file. So to upload and click on upload theme, and from here choose file and choose your location. I have saved that on desktop. Where it is, DV theme. Yeah, this is it. This is the file. Choose this file and click on open and click on install now. So as you can see the progress over here at the bottom left corner of your Chrome browser. If you're using Chrome browser, it's 17-18%, whatever it is. So by the time your theme is getting uploaded, I would recommend you guys to go ahead and subscribe to my channel and also give a thumbs up to this video. And I have also made different videos how to create an e-commerce website, how to create a parallax website, how to create a social network website. So if you're interested, you can go ahead and watch those videos also. My username is Nayar Sheikh. You can do what you can do is clear, go to youtube.com/Nayar Sheikh and you will be redirected to my page. Okay. So this is my channel. You can go ahead and click on subscribe over here and you can enjoy all my videos, which are all free, no restricted videos. Okay, so make sure you do this. After installing the theme, click on activate. Okay, so we have successfully activated the TV theme. Now before doing anything else, first delete these creepy themes because we don't need this. These are all default themes by WordPress and we don't basically need this. So just go ahead and delete these themes. Now again, come back to your website and click on the refresh button to see the changes that has taken place. Okay, we don't see much change on the website. As you can see, it is still nothing close to this beauty. So again, let's do that. Come back to your dashboard. And first we have to do the homepage. We'll create the homepage. But before that, I would recommend and suggest to you guys to go to my website blogdude.com and open this How to Make a WordPress Website 2017 DB tutorial. I have a direct link for this page given in the video description below. So go ahead and do that. And from here also you can see the download link, DB theme download link, HostGator download link. And now what you have to do, suppose you want to use the images which I have used. For example, this is the image for the background, the video which I showed, and these different images. Then go ahead and click on images download, click on this download button and the download will start over here, as you can see, because I don't want to download this because I already have these images and all these files. You can also download the layouts. What are layouts? I'll explain you later. Layout is basically just to simplify your life. It really makes your life so easy. I'll teach you later in this tutorial if you stay with me till the end. Fine, so this is a very important page. Okay, so again, come back over here and hover pages and click on add new, because now we have to add a new page, a home page, and make that home page look something like this. So for that, first we have to create a page. You can put any title for the page. I basically put home page and click on publish. Now click on use the TV builder. Now click on use visual builder. Okay, so this is our visual builder. Now I'll show you how to work with visual builder. It is really easy, and most of the more important than being easy, it is really exciting and amazing working with visual builder. So first we have to add this section, as you can see, a full width section. So for that, when you hover here, you see this plus blue plus button, just click on that. This is to add a new section. So click on that. Click on full width. As you can see, the section over here is a full width section. It stretches, left and right. And from here, you have different options. What you have to select is, let me minimize this. This one, full width slider. Fine. Okay. And now you have to add a new item. Basically, this is a item, where we have a header, a subtitle, call to action button, and a different background. And when we go to different section or go to the another slider, this is another item. So basically, having two items over here. So we have to add this first item. Let's copy this text. Fine. So click over here, add a new item, and put in the heading. Okay, so this was the heading, and put in the button text. As you can see here, it says try it now. You can put in anything, like click here, button URL, the URL on which you want to redirect the button. And from background image, click on upload, and the images which you have downloaded from my website, you can use those images. If you have your own image, you can use that also. Or else you can go to Pixabay or, you know, Unsplash, where you can find many professional images for free. So that is awesome. Now click on Select Files. And I have all the images over here. So what I'll do is select all and click on Open. So I don't have to, you know, upload images one by one. I'm uploading all the images which are needed in the website. And basically it will take some time to upload all the images. So for that, I'm pausing this video. After all these images are been uploaded, I'll continue. Okay, so now all our images have been uploaded. So what you have to do in the background image, click on upload, select the image. So this is the image, as you can see, and click on upload an image. Okay, so as you can see the changes over here, the image has been uploaded, and there are many different options. As you can see, first is the position. So you have different positions, center, top left, you know, all these kind of positions. You can set it anything. I have put it as default. Then we have background image size. Make sure it is cover, fine. Then instead of image, you can put a background color also. It's all up to you. Then we have a background overlay. And what is that? Let's see what that is. Suppose you want an overlay color, for example, yellow color. As you can see, this is the overlay color, and you can reduce the transparency, and this is how it will look. As you can see, you can change the color, green color, blue color. You can change the transparency if you like. You can keep these changes also, but I basically don't want that. I think it looks really cool without even the overlay. Fine. Then we have slide, vertical section, slide video. We don't need these kind of settings. Text color, at present it is white. You can change this to dark, to black, but obviously dark doesn't look anything over here. So we have light. We have some different options in the design section. So before going on, we have a content over here. So this is the content. So let's copy this and paste over here. So as you can see, this is the content. Fine. Now let's go to the design section. This is the design section. It says arrow custom color. At present, we cannot see any arrow because we have only one slide. And obviously in one slide, we won't have any arrow. When we have more than one slide, we'll have the arrow. Let's come to the demo website. And as you can see, when we hover over the website, we see this arrow here. So this is the arrow. And here it's asking for the custom arrow color. So if you want some different color, at present it is white, and I basically think white is perfect. If you want some different colors, you can select custom arrow color for red or whatever you want. But I don't want any changes over here. If you want, you can do some changes. Then we have custom dot navigation color. So here is the dot navigation. As you can see, two small dots. So you can also change that color. I don't want to change that either. Fine. Then we have text overlay border radius. We don't need that also. Then we have header font. This is the header font. As you can see, this is the header. You can change the font of the header. You have many different beautiful fonts. You know, you can go with Roboto. You have Roboto also here. As you can see, the font changes. You have different, you know, fonts. Obviously you have Oswald and many different fonts, but I would like to stick with the default font. You can change the font size also from here, as you can see. So basically you don't have to do any coding whatsoever. It's just drag and drop, and you have to click here and there. You can, you know, do it bold. You can make it italicized, whatever. You can just some clicks. You can change the color of this also. You know, you can make it red. You can make any color you want, but obviously white was looking cool. So I think white is fine. Then we have letter spacing. As you can see, when we increase the letter spacing, the changes you can see over here. So you can increase or decrease the letter spacing. Here's the letter spacing. And if you want to make this default, so you can click on this reset button. So it will go to default. Then we can also increase the line height. As you can see, when we do so, the line height increases. Make this default also. Then we have the body font size. You can change the body font size, is the body font. You can change this color also, and you can also change the spacing for this also. Fine. Then you can also change the line height. Basically, the options are repetitive throughout the website. You can use custom style for button. For example, suppose you want to change some styling of this button, then you can just click on yes over here. Then we have button text size. As you can see here, it is written click here, so you can change the size of that button. Okay, then we have button text. Text color at present is white. You can make it any color. For example, just click on red and here it will be red. Then we have button background color. As you can see, background at present is transparent. We can change that. We can make it yellow, we can make it anything, but obviously it really looks bad. So keep this as default. I would suggest you guys to keep this as default. Okay, then we have border radius. As you can see, when we increase the border radius increases. Border color, the button border color, at present it is white. You can change the border color to anything you want. As you can see, the changes over here. So it's all up to you. I'm just showing you the options and what that option does. Whether you want to use that or not, it's all up to you. And here, as you can see, there is an icon over here. You can change this icon also. You have many different icons over here. You can select any from here and use that over here. For example, suppose we want this icon, the headphone icon. So we can say, as you can see, the icon has changed. And whenever you select different icons, the icon will be changed over here. And you can also change the color of the icon. Button icon color, you can select any different color. And as you can see, now everything is constant except for the color of the icon. So obviously you can do that also. Don't need that, but I just showed you. Okay, you can, there's an option which says only show icon or on hover for button. So when you hover over the icon, we see the button. But if you want to show the button with or without hover, you can do so. Basically, I don't want to do any changes in the button, so I'll just make this no. And after you're done with this, just click on this tick button two times. And as you can see, we have a lot of space over here, but here we don't have any space, it is the first section. So let's delete this section. As you can see, when you hover here, we get this option, section option. Just delete this section. So this is our first section now. Now we have to add the background video. We have to add another slide and add a video in the background for that slide. So let's do that. Just click on this gear icon to make some changes. This is the changes for this module. Now we have to add another item. So click on add new item. Now we have to add this section. As you can see, we have a background video. So we have a headline, a sub headline. So come here, put in the heading. Okay, first let's come to this. Okay, now put in the text. Fine. Now scroll down. Here you see background video MP4. So we can insert a video in the background. Just click on upload. This file is also included in the images file which you have just downloaded from my website. So select this, click on upload a video, and after everything is fine, you can click okay. Okay, this is not the button text. Oh, I'm sorry. Just scroll down. This is our content. So paste it over here. Now we have the content, and now you can click on this tick button. So now we have two slides, an image and a video slide. Fine. But as you can see here, this section is a full width section, and here this section is quite small. We'll do that later at the end of this video. For now, let's keep on adding different sections. Now let's add the another section, the services section. So for that, obviously, again, you hover here and click on this plus button to add a new section and click on regular. Now click on one row, because you know now we have to add this thing, the heading and the subheading. So basically it's just a single row, and when we'll add the images, we'll use three rows. For now we'll use only one row. First let's copy this because we'll need this. Now select the one row option, and for now to add a text, you have many different options. You can add it through blurb, you can add through call to action, you can add through HTML, you can add through text obviously, but I basically prefer the call to action because that is very easy to do. Now in the title you can put in services, fine. You can also put a button, suppose anything, you can put anything. I don't want any button over here. And I don't want the background color also, because we don't want this background color. So just make this no. And the text color should be dark so that we can see it. And in the content, just type in the subheadline. Fine. And you can see some different options over here. If you want a background color, you can have that. Now come to design. This is the header. This is the header font size. I personally prefer, and I would recommend all you guys watching this video, to make your header size 40, and it should be consistent throughout the video, throughout the website. Wherever you're using header, make that as 40 pixels so that it gives a kind of consistency in your website. Then we have header text color. You can change the text color. I like the black color, so I'm not changing it. Then you have letter spacing. I am putting 10 pixels, and make sure this spacing also is kind of repeating throughout the website so that it really gives a good look. You can change the line height. I don't want to change that. Then we have the body font size. I prefer 16 pixels for this. Then you can change the text color for this also. You can change the spacing for this. Okay, you can have a background image for this. You can add some custom padding or custom margin for this. We don't want to do that. So after you do this, just click on this tick button. Now we have added this. Now it's time to add these three beautiful images with this title and subtitle. So obviously again, now we don't have to add a new section because we already have a section. We have to add a row in this section. So when you hover here, you have this option, this plus sign over here which says add new row. So click on that, and now you have to select three columns, or if you want to make more services then four columns or two, whatever you like. I like three columns, so select this. And now from here select the blurb option. You can put any title. For example, I'm putting title 1. Okay, you can put any URL. I'm not putting any URL at present right now. And URL opens in the same video or a new tab. It's all up to you. You can use an icon, but we are not using icon. We are using image in this example. We'll be using icon in the testimonial section, but now we are using image. So now we have to upload the image. Select the image you want. This is the image we have used. So select and click on upload an image. Now the image placement or position, you can select that. Then we have the animation. What should be the animation for the image? Top to bottom, left to right. We have different options. Because this is an image on the left side, left to right would be better. Then text color. I prefer the dark text color. Then we have text orientation, center. Here we have center text orientation. So, go ahead with center only. Then put in some small description about the service. After you do so, just click on this button and you have the first service over here. Now instead of repeating the same step three times, what you can do, just hover here and you have this copy option. Just click on this copy option, and as you can see, now we have the same thing two times. Now what you have to do, just drag this module over here. Okay, so this is really useful. Instead of doing and repeating the same step again and again, this really saves our time. Now I have to change the title, so don't have to go to settings to do so. Just select this, put in 2, and as you can see, now it becomes title 2. Now we have to change the image, so again hover here and click on this gear icon, scroll down, click on upload and select the different image, this one, click on upload an image, click on this button. Now again, let's copy this and drag it over here. Title 3 it should be, and now we have to change the background image. So gear icon, scroll down, click on the upload button, select the image, same step. And as you can see, it is so easy. You know, as I said in the beginning, creating a website was never this easy. You know, it is so easy to create a website. And if you were to create this two section, only this two section from scratch, you know, using code, then your life would be terrible. You know, if you're not a programmer, your life would be terrible. But really, TV makes our life really easy. That's why I like TV, and it's good for everyone, you know. So this is the services section. Now let's add this section, the who we are section. Let's copy this text because we'll need this. Okay, now we have to, before proceeding, now let's save the file. Click over here, click on save. You can also save this by clicking on Control and S. So this is very important so that you don't miss all the changes. Suppose electricity goes up or any bad thing happens and you realize that all your efforts are gone, you have to do everything from the beginning. So just to avoid that, make sure you keep on saving the changes whatever you do. Now let's add another section. Click over here, click on regular. Now let's see what we have. We have two different, you know, rows. First row is this text and the second row is the image. So now we have to select these two rows. Fine. In the first row we have this, some text and a heading, a header text and some regular content. So for that, select call to action. In the title, put in who we are. Okay, we don't want background color. Now select this and paste it over here. Now click on this OK button, but we cannot see the changes because the text color is white and here we have a background. So first let's add this background image before going further. Okay, to add a background in this section, what you have to do, hover here and click on this section setting button, the icon, and select the background image. Click on upload. This is the image we have used, geometric bg till the name of the image, whatever it is. Select this, click on upload an image, click on this button, and as you can see, we have this over here. But there are some changes. As you can see, the size of this font is bigger and it is justified, it is not justified. So let's do that again. Click on this setting over here, come down, you know, in the content, select everything, and here you have the justified section. Just click on this and everything should be fine now. And now, as I said, header font size should be consistent throughout the website, so just make it 40. And body font size should also be consistent. We have kept it as 16, so let's do that 16 and click on OK. So we have this. Now we have to add the image. Obviously it is really easy, just click on this plus button over here and from here select image. Here it is. Click on upload image. It's really simple doing this. Really cool, really awesome, good experience. Select the image, click on upload an image. Okay, now you have many different options. You have animation, URL open scene option. You know, you can link this image to different website, to different page if you want. Fine. After you do so, just click on OK. So we have this section also. But as you can see, there isn't any gap over here. And this really looks cool. You know, the image starts in this section. So what we have to do, we have to remove this gap from here. So doing that also is really simple. Just drag this to the top. Fine. Okay, now this looks exactly like the demo website. Now we have to add the another section, the R members section. So obviously, again, the same steps. Click on this, add a new section, a regular section, single row. Select call to action because, you know, we want this single row heading and subheading over here. In the title, you can put R members, fine, and some dummy text in the content. Okay, we don't want the background color. Also, the text color should be dark, so select dark from here. Again, go to design and make this as 40. Letter spacing 10 pixels. And body font size should be 16 pixels. Just to have that consistency throughout the website. Now click on save changes. Okay, now we have to add these three images, different images. So again, now we don't have to add a new section, as you know, as you might have experienced, you know, now because you are following the website, you're following this tutorial, now you know, basically have an idea how, you know, to do this. Now to do so, we have to add a new row and we have to select three column row. So select this. And to add this kind of section, we have to select the person module. You'll see here the person module. Select that. The name of the person, just type in any name. I'm typing Nayashek, my own name. Position, you can put in anything. You can put the image. So this is a guy. Let's use this image. Upload an image. Fine. You can see the changes over here. You can drag this thing anywhere on the website so that you can see the changes which are taking place on the website. Fine. The text color is dark. You can, you know, put in profile URL, all this thing over here. And as I do so, as you can see, the buttons are started appearing. The LinkedIn button is not yet there. But when I put the URL for the LinkedIn, the button appears over here. You know, you have to put a very short description about the person. So just copy some text and paste it over here. Fine. So it looks exactly like this. And within few seconds, we have done that. Now click on save changes. Now, obviously, again, instead of repeating the same steps, let's copy this thing and drag it over here. And again, let's copy this image also and drag it over here. Now, what we have to do is click on setting and, you know, change the name and position, everything. So you can put in any name. Because we have a female, I'm putting some different name. It can be anything, you know, it can be designer. You can put managing director according to your website, what kind of website you're making. Image URL or image selection. This is a cute girl. So let's upload this image. Click on save changes. Again, settings, change the name. You can put any name, obviously. Position, you can put anything. Change the image. Save changes. Now we have completed the member section also. Now we have this our mission section. So let's do that again. Add a new section. Click on regular. First, we have to add this heading and subheading. So a single row will be enough for that. And we always use call to action for heading and subheading. Fine. In title, you can type in our mission. Okay. Then we have some text over here. Let's copy and paste this text. if you know, sometimes if you face this problem in copying and pasting, so what you can do is go to text section and delete everything and paste that text over here, so you won't face any problem. And now, as you can see, it really looks cool. Fine, we don't want the background color, so just make this no. Text color should be dark for black. Now click on this design option and obviously make the same changes, 40 pixels for font size, header font size, spacing is 10 pixels, body is 16 pixels. Now click on save changes. Okay, now we have to add this two columns. Before that, let's add this background image so that we can see the changes, because now we'll be adding this, you know, white text all around, so we will not be able to see that unless we have something in background. So let's add an background image. This is the image we have used, Salmon. Click on upload an image, click on OK. And this doesn't look good, the black doesn't look good on this background. So what you can do is change this color. However, here click on the gear icon and drag down text color, make it as light, save changes. This looks cool. Now we have to add two different columns. So first let's add a row. So however, here click on this add new row and select this two column row. In the first column we have some text, so let's copy this text, come over here, select call to action. We don't want anything in the title, just in the content we want this. Fine, here it is, select everything. Okay, we were not in the, paste it over here, select everything and left align this text. And we don't want this background color, so make background color no. Again, come to design, this should be 16, as you know. So we haven't used header in this option, we have used only body, so make body font as 16. As you can see, the changes have taken place. Now click on save changes. Now we have to add this beautiful progress bar. So for that, click on this plus button over here. Scroll down, you'll see something called bar counters over here. Okay, here you have to, let's make this, drag this over here. Click on add new item. Basically, these are items. Creativity is a different item. Design is a different item, management is a different item. So basically this is how it is. So in the title, first put creativity or whatever you want to put, and you can put any percentage. We are putting 95%. We'll see the designing later. First let's add the three different items. Click on save changes, add a new item. We have design, it should be 85%, you know, obviously design is 100%, our design is 100% awesome, but just to show you, I have put some different numbers over here. Then we have management, it doesn't make any sense, management, design and creativity, but just put in something, 65%. Click on OK. Now we have to, you know, do some changes in the designing. The text color is dark, but we don't want dark, we want light. As you can see, now the changes have taken place. Background color is cool, this is the color and it really looks cool on this salmon color. We want to use percentages, obviously we do want to use that. Now come to the design option, there is border radius, you can increase or decrease the border radius. Title font, you can increase the font size over here, so let's do that because this is very small. Okay, so I think 20 is cool. Now let's increase the spacing. Okay, 4 or 5 will be fine for this. Then we have title line height, I think it's fine, we don't need any changes. Percentage font size, let's increase this because as you can see this is a bit larger and bigger than this one. So let's increase this. Not this one, this one. Percentage font size. 17 is looking fine. Now what we have to do is select this, use border. Okay, border style should be dashed. So as you can see, the dashed border over here. Fine, after that click on save changes. But as you can see in the demo website, this is not a rectangle shape. This is, you know, somewhat we have some radius, border radius over here. So let's do that. We forgot to do that. So click on this setting, click on this gear icon. Under design, this is the border radius. So let's put some border radius. 20 is looking good. 1920 would be fine. Let's make this 20. This is really looking cool. Now click on save changes. So we have completed this section also very easily, very nicely. Now let's do the another section, which is the testimonial section. But first let's save. Obviously don't forget to save the file whenever you make any changes. Do save it. Now let's add a new section, regular section, the same step obviously. A single row. Then select the call to action button. In the title, put in testimonials. Then we don't want background color. And the color is dark. So select the text color as dark. Then we have some dummy text. Then under content, paste in the dummy text. Again, as you can see, when we paste it, we see a lot of gap over here. Obviously, again, there is some problem with the visual settings. So what you can do is just delete everything from here. Go to text, and here you have some coding already. So what you can do, just delete this text and paste your text or type your text in the text section instead of visual section. So just paste it over here. As you can see now, it looks fine. After doing so, click on design and let's keep this over here and do the same step. 40 pixels for header. Fine. Spacing should be 10 pixels. Then we have body font size as 16 pixels. Fine. And rest everything is fine. So click on save changes. Now we have to add these three testimonials. So again, we have to add a new row. So click on over here, add a new row, three column row, because we want to add three different testimonials. Now from here, select testimonials module. Here it is. Author name can be any name. Let me put my friend's name. Job title, maybe manager. Company name, manager of, let me make his my own manager blog dude. You can, you know, put in the company's URL over here, and you can choose where to open, in the same window or in another image. Then we have portrait image URL. Just upload any image. Let's upload this guy's image. Fine, as you can see the changes over here. And we do want to use the background color over here, because, you know, in this white section, as you can see, there is a gray color background image, which looks cool. So from background color, just select a bit darker gray. This is fine. This is fine. Text alignment, you can choose whether left or center. I like the center, and the text should be dark. Text color should be dark. Orientation should be center, as I said. Now you can put in his words. What do you want to say? What is his testimonial for you over here? So here we have the first testimonial. You can remove this icon from here if you want. Here is the option, quote icon. If you put this as hidden, that will be removed. If you put this as visible, that will be visible, obviously. Fine, after that click on save changes, and again instead of doing the same thing again and again, just copy this, drag this over here. Fine, again copy and drag this one over here. Fine, and again, like all every time, we can click on this gear icon, make all the changes, you know, the job title, the image, everything can be changed from here. And after you do so, click on save changes, so you can change the images from here, you can change the person's name, his designation, his company's name, everything can be changed from here. So we have completed the testimonial section also. Now let's put this, you know, beautiful gallery section. So again, click on add new section from here, regular. Here we have four different images, so select four columns from here, and from this module select image and put in image URL or select any image for that. So let's start selecting one by one. Let's select this image first, click on upload an image. Let's scroll down. So this is the image, we have the image right now. Let's copy so that we don't have to repeat the same settings again and again. Drag it over here, copy, drag it over here, again copy and drag. Okay, now let's change the images. Just click on this gear icon, click on upload, select an image, upload an image, save changes, repeat this step, change the image, select the image, click on upload an image. Fine, everything is going fine. Okay, so we have uploaded four different images, but obviously, as you can see, this looks beautiful, this doesn't look that good. So we have to change this design. So for that, come over here, the row setting, click on the row setting and make this row full width. Okay, and also select this use custom gutter width, make this as yes, and bring it back to 1, and instead of 1 just put 0, because we don't want any gutter, we don't want any space. Actually, gutter is the space between two different columns, so we want that as 0. After that, click on save changes. Now we have another option in DB. You can copy the whole, you know, the whole section and just paste it over here. So as you can see, instead of repeating these steps again, we have just copied the whole section, all the changes have taken place. Now we have to change the image, only the image. So let's start doing that. Let's put in an image. Fine. And make sure the size of all the images are, you know, same. For example, in this I'm using the image size as 390 into 300. So if all the images size are same, it really looks cool, it doesn't have any gap between. Fine, but as you can see, there is a gap over here, so we have to, you know, remove this gap from here. Okay, now we don't want and we don't have any gap over here, and this really looks cool. Now let's save the changes and see the another section. The another section is the post section, the block section. So let's add a new section, regular, single row, call to action. And in the title, you can put anything. I'm putting latest post. And in the text, some dummy text. Fine. We don't want any background color. And the text color should be dark. The designing 40 pixels for the header font size, 10 pixels letter spacing, then 16 pixels for body font size, and click on save changes. Now save this page over here from here. And before proceeding, because we have some different blocks over here, we obviously have to create different blocks before putting this thing over here. Okay, let's see how a block looks like. Okay, so this is how a post looks like in TV theme. This is really clean and professional. So now let's start adding the blog post. So what you can do is hover over here and click on post. And here you have you can put in the title. For example, this is the title. You can put any title over here. Select the visual. And you have to put all these things. So you basically know how to make a blog, how to write a blog. So it's just like Microsoft Word. You have almost the same options over here. Fine. After doing so, you can select the format. Make sure it is standard. If you're using a video over here, you can put in video, and you have different formats for this. And instead of going over here and creating categories, you can create a category from here also. For example, just click on add new category, and you can put any category you want. For example, let's say we want a design category. Just click on add new category. You can also put some tags for this. For example, let's put design only for tag. So it is done. You can add a featured image. This is a featured image. Fine. So let's add an image as a featured image. This is the image. Click on save featured image. As you can see over here. Now click on publish. So we have successfully published our first post. Similarly, we can create any number of posts we want. Okay, so we have successfully created three different posts. That would be fine and enough for our homepage. So again, come back over here, click on pages, click on homepage. You can view this page in a new tab. Let's view this page. And if you want to make any changes on the page, you just can click on enable visual builder over here. Okay, now let's scroll down to the latest post section and scroll over here, hover over here, and click on add new row. And we want a single row. Let me show you how it happens. We have to select block from here. You know, you have different layout option, layout full width, then number of posts. Make this as 3 or 4, whatever you want. Include categories. Obviously, we want to include the design category. Date format, to make this as same. We want the featured image, obviously. We do want to show the excerpt. If we want, we can show the author, date, and categories, as you can see. Over here we have the author, date, category. Text color should be black. Fine. In the layout option, select grid. Okay, so our block section is also done. So click on save changes. Now let's come back to the demo website and see what all things are left. Okay, we have done the block section. Now we have to put this thing a map. So again, come back over here, where is that, and click on add a new section. Click on regular, a single row, and from here select map. For that we need a Google API key. Let me show you how you can get that. First let's save this. Save the page so that we don't miss any changes over here, and go to the link console.developers.google.com. Click on credentials over here and just copy this API key. Come back to your dashboard, and here you'll see the DB option. Click on the DB option. But for you, it might not be this easy, because if you have not yet created a, you know, account on the developers page. So for that, for your help, I have given a link to a video in the video description below that will help you creating a link, creating account over here, how to create the API key. So after that, you just have to copy the API key from here and come back over here and paste in the Google API key over here and click on save changes. So make sure you see that video, that would really help you. After you do so, again, come back over here, refresh this page so that we can see the changes, the map over here. Okay, now let's scroll down. Okay, here is the map option. Just click on the settings over here. Now, as you can see, we have the API key already over here. Now, first click on add new item. You can put any title you want. For example, location, or maybe you can put in your company's name, for example, Blogdude. Then map address, I'm staying at Mumbai, so I'll put Mumbai, and then click on find. Now here you can put in your address, for example, Cyan Mumbai 40022, I guess, yeah. Click on save changes. Then here, put in Mumbai, the same address which you have put in the item, and click on find. Okay, here you have the map. You can increase or decrease the size of the map, and you can also, you know, make these changes yes or no. I would say no to this, just off this setting, because sometimes what happens, you know, when you're scrolling in the website, the image gets zoomed in and zoomed out, so we don't want that. So make both this thing off, and make, suppose you want to make this thing, you know, some smaller, you can zoom out from here. Okay, this is our beautiful Mumbai. So just click on save changes, and now click over here, hover here, and click on row settings. And obviously make this row full width. Then use custom gutter width and make this as 0. And click on save changes. Fine, so we have the map now. Now let's add this footer, and we'll be using this footer throughout the website, and I'll show you how easily you can use this footer or any of this section. You know, we can save this section and we can use anywhere in the website. So let's do this. Come here, hover here, click on add new section, click on regular. Now select this one, four column row, and select blur from your title. This is the title, as you can see here. Address is the title, so copy and paste it over here. You can, you know, redirect this to any URL if you want. And here we have to say yes, we want to use icon, and let's search for the icon. You know, you can use this icon for the address. I have used another icon over here, but you can use any icon, obviously. Icon color, here it is white. So what we can do is select white from here and click on save changes, because we don't want to make any change right now, because we cannot see these changes. First, we have to, you know, change the background color so that we can see the changes over here. So let's do that. Let's change the section setting. Now we are not using a background image, we are using a background color. So select color. You can use any color, you can, you know, make this thing up or down for using the lighter or darker version of that color. This looks fine. Now click on save changes. Now hover here and let's change the setting of this module. So we have selected the icon. Now the image or icon placement should be left. Fine. And we can choose the animation, the text orientation and everything, the text color should be light. Fine. Then here in the content, you can put in your address. I'm just copying and pasting some dummy address from somewhere in the world. Fine. Now we have to change the size of the heading, the icon. So for that, come over here in the design section. Okay. And make this yes. Use icon font size. And just change this from here. This is 90. And I think 90 is fine. Just increase the header font size to 22 maybe. And rest everything is looking fine. You know, you have to adjust this according to you. If you find 25 is awesome, 25 is looking good, make this 25. If you think 18 is looking good, make this 18. There is no hard and fast, or there is no restricted amount of numbers that, you know, suppose you have. It's not like you have to make it 22 only. That's not the case. You can choose your own design, whatever you like, and make this as your default style. So now click on save changes. Again, let's copy this so that we don't have to do the same steps again and again. Now we have to change the icon and all the things. Here we have the phones. Let's copy these phone numbers. Instead of address, now we'll have phones. Okay, you can have a URL, whatever you want. Now in the content, just paste those phone numbers. And use a different icon obviously for that. We have many different icons over here. You can select any, whichever you want. Let's see a good icon for phone. This one looks fine. Here I have used a different one. Here I'm using different one. You can use anything which you like. And again, now we don't have to change the design obviously because we have copied. So we have copied the settings for design also. This is the benefit of copying. Obviously, copying is always beneficial. Click on save changes. Now again, copy this. We are good at copying. Just drag it over here. Click on this setting. Now we have something called email. Okay, so let's change the title to email, and let's change the email address, and let's also change the icon. Let's select the envelope icon. Here it is. This is the envelope icon. Fine. And from content, put in your email address over here. I have put in my email address. If you guys have any queries, you can feel free to contact me through email address, or you can, you know, put in a comment in the comment section below. I'll try my best to reach out to you guys and help you. Click on save changes. Now we have another one, which is time. Let's copy this so that we don't have to now do the same settings again, the design settings. We save some time with that. Click on settings. Instead of address, we have time, I guess. Again, from here, select any icon for time, clock icon. Okay. Here it is. This is the clock icon, and you can change the email address from here. So with this, just expand this setting, click on save. With this, we have completed the home section. No, we haven't completed. Actually, we haven't done this gapping system. Let's improve the gapping. As you can see, there is a lot of gap between the map and this footer section. Where else here we don't have any gap. So let's improve all the gaps in this website. So what you can do is just remove all the gaps from here. Fine, we want zero gap from here. Okay, now this is looking cool. Here also there is a lot of gap. You don't want this much gap obviously. Just remove all these gaps. fine. Okay, so this is fine now. Here also a lot of gap, you don't want this much gap over here. Or if you want, you can have it, but I don't want, there is just a lot of gap, I think. And I don't want this much gap. Fine. Here it is fine, testimonial gap is fine. Here also it is good. Okay, so here the gapping, okay, huh, fine. Rest everything is fine. Click on save changes. And as I said, we'll do these changes over here. The section is very small, whereas in the demo section, as you can see, this section is full width. So what you can do is click over here, and from here, click on this page setting and go back to that link, to my website link. And here you have a very small piece of code. Just copy this, come back over here, and in the CSS option, paste that. As you can see, but just when we pasted that, the changes took place over here. Now click on save changes. And also, as you can see, the menu, the header menu we have is almost transparent, and here we don't have that. So let's make that transparent. So first click on save changes. Fine. Now hover here and click on theme customizer. Here in the header and navigation section, just select this header format. You can change the header format. You know, it is at present default. You can have centered inline logo. You know, the logo comes in center and everything. I like the default one. You can change that if you want. Then primary menu bar, come over here. You can increase or decrease the height of the menu bar. As you can see, you can increase or decrease this height. I am keeping it as default. Now here, okay, here is the background color. So select this, select black from here, and here we have to reduce the transparency. Okay, as you can see, we have reduced the transparency, and now we cannot see the text color over here. So we have to change the text color. Select text color from here and select white. Okay, now we have the white color as the text color. So this really looks cool now. You know, when we scroll down, this also, let's make it a little less transparent. So because we cannot see the image over here. So just a little bit. Fine. This is fine now. Okay, fine. So once you do that, just click on save and publish. Also, we have to make this as our home page. Let me show you what do I mean by that. Just open this website div3.blogtoot.com. As you can see, we are seeing some creepy page over here. We should not be seeing this page. We want this page, you know, this page to be displaying as the home page. So for that, come back, and here you'll see something called static front page. So from there, select a static page, and from front page, select home page, the page which we have created. This is the home page. Okay, select that and click on save and publish. And now when we refresh this page, we'll see the changes. As you can see, now we can see the home page has become the official home page. Fine. And this is really looking cool. Okay, so once you do all these changes, just click on this X button over here. I also wanted to tell you about one more setting. For example, when you hover over here, let's change the setting for this one. This is a very special, very important setting. Let's click on setting, and this is available for all the section, all the different modules. When we click on design, as you can see, this is the header font, but it is not necessary that this is how it will look in the mobile. Let me show you what I mean by that. Here is an icon, mobile icon, just click on that. And from here, desktop is selected, select smartphone. So it will tell you how your website will look like in a smartphone, as you can see. So this is how your website will look, and we don't like this. We don't want our heading, you know, in three lines. So what you can do is, change this header font size. Fine. So this is the header font size. Now this changes won't take place for desktop. For desktop, it will be same. For example, let's click on desktop. As you can see, it is same. But when we see the smartphone, the size has changed. And this is really good. Fine. Now we have to change the size for this also, the body text. So let's come back, come down over here. Body font size, again click the mobile button from here. Make sure smartphone is selected. And again decrease the size of this text also. Fine, this is just too small. Okay, click on save changes. That is very important. Okay, fine. So make sure you look at that changes for all this section. For all this section, you make sure you see that changes. So we have done the page. Now we have to do the menus. As you can see, we don't have anything. Whereas in the demo website, when you click on services, we are redirected to the services section. So for that, first we have to give a class to a class ID to all the different sections. How we do that? Let me show you. Let's come to this services section. When we hover over here, just come on to this setting, section setting. And in this CSS, in the CSS ID, you can put any ID for this section. You can put just a number, 1 or 2, you know, or you can put any different numbers or any different text. And just for the sake of simplicity, I'm putting services so that we know that this is the ID for services section. Fine, click on save changes. Similarly, for about us section, do the same step. About us, fine. Then we have member section, settings, CSS, and in the CSS ID, members, click on save changes. Then we have mission section, again setting, CSS, in the CSS ID, put in mission or anything you want, just to, you know, name this section. You can put any ID for this section. Then the testimonials, repeat the same steps. Testimonials. This is the gallery section. The spelling for gallery in your country may differ. This is the blog section. We'll name it as blog section. Fine. Then we have the last contact us section. So just click over here, CSS, contact us. Fine, click on save changes. Just click on over here, make sure you save these settings. Now we have add a menu over here. As you can see, this is not a proper menu. We have to add a menu. So come back to your dashboard from over here, click on dashboard. And over here, you'll see something called appearances, hover appearances, and click on menus. Now we put in any menu name you want. I'm putting menu 1. You can put main menu, whatever you want. Just a simple name for a menu. And now we have to add this options, this section options. So what you do is click on custom links. And in the URL, put in hashtag sign and type services. Type the custom ID, the CSS ID for this section. So this was the CSS ID for services, and put in a hashtag sign before that ID. So basically it's hashtag sign, and after that sign, the CSS ID of that section, and link text will be services obviously. Click on add to menu and make sure primary menu is selected. Now let's see the another section, about us section. So again, same step, about us, the link text, it would be about us. Click on add to menu. That's another section. It is members section. Okay. Then we have our mission section. Fine. Then we have testimonials. Then we have gallery section. Then blog section. Then I guess, yeah, the contact us section is the last section. Just put in contact us. Fine. Click on add to menu. After that, click on save menu. Come back to your website. Refresh your website and you should see the changes right now. Okay guys, so we can see the changes on our menus. As you can see, now let's see whether it works or not. Let's click on our members, and as you can see, we are directed to this. We are directed to this section. Let's click on testimonials. Okay, so this works fine. This works really awesome. Now let me show you how to create different sections, different pages. As I said in the beginning, I'll be creating different pages also. This was the tutorial for one page website, and suppose you want to add some external pages, then how you do that I'll teach you now. And I also said you, I'll tell you something about the layouts which you have downloaded from here. Now let me show you what those layouts are, and that is really awesome. So let's add a new page. Click hover here on new and click on page. Now let's add the about us page first. Here is the about us page in the demo section. So let's add about us page over here. Click on publish. Now click on view page. And here click on enable visual builder. Fine. So instead of repeating all the same steps, adding a new section, adding a new row, then putting this module, what you can do is just click on over here. And here you see this last option, import export option. So under that, click on import, click on choose file, and choose the file from these pages. You'll see that in the layouts option. And from here, choose about us and click on open. And over here, click import DB builder layout. And as you can see, you already have the whole layout over here. Now you don't have to do anything. You just have to change the images, the logos from here. Suppose you want to change this logo. So what you do is just click on this gear icon. Let's make this over here. And instead of this icon, put in any different icon. As you can see, click on OK. You can change this. So after doing that, your work becomes very easy. Everything is formatted very carefully. All the spacing have been done. Everything is done. You just have to change the images or different things. And suppose you don't want any section. If you don't want this section, you can just delete this section. Okay. And you have your page ready. And you can also press Ctrl Z for undo. Okay, so let's do that. So let's save this section, and I'll be adding many more layouts in the future. Fine, so we have successfully created our about us page within few seconds. You just have to change this text, which is very simple. I have taught you how to do that in the home page section. Now let's add another page. So click on hover pages, hover new and select page. And let's add the contact us page now. Just type in contact us. Click on publish. Click on view page. Enable visual builder. Again, do the same thing. Click on import, select the file, and this time select the contact us file. Select open, click on import DB builder layout. We have everything over here. Just change the address from here. Click on this setting and new item setting. From here, you have to change the address, which is at present Mumbai. So if you are in New York, change this to New York, your specific address. You can change everything from here. So you have the layout, you just have to change some text over here. And this is a very important setting, just hover yours, click on over here. And in this, in the email option, put in your email address where you want, you know, all this information to be sent to which email address. So put in that email address. Make sure you do so. If you don't do, this form won't work fine. So make sure you put in your email address over here. And again, suppose you want to change any thing over here, you can just change anything, you can type anything from here. Fine, just click on Control Z. So with this, you have created the contact us page. You just have to do some basic changes, which is very easy. Now let's add the portfolio page. Hover new, click on page. Put the title as portfolio, click on publish. Click on view page. Click on enable visual builder. And again, instead of doing everything from scratch, just import my layout, portfolio layout, and everything will be done over here. Fine, you can change the text from here, but you don't see the portfolios over here because we haven't created any portfolio. So this is the only thing we'll have to do. So just click on save. Fine. Exit visual builder. Now hover page new and select project. Open this in a new tab. I'll show you how to create a project or a portfolio that it will show up over here. And now let's see the demo portfolio page also, so that you get an idea how it looks like. So this is how your portfolio will look like after you enter all the projects. So let's add a new project first. Let's put a simple title, project 1. You can add a category like portfolio 1. You can add any category, obviously. Add something or write something about your portfolio. Put in some dummy text over here. Fine. Put in some dummy text over here. And after that, select the featured image. And you can select any featured image. Suppose we want this one. So select this. Click on set featured image. Now click on publish. Okay, so you have successfully created one project. Now similarly, you can create n number of projects. Now let's refresh this and see whether we can see that project over here or not. So as you can see, when we refresh, we have this project over here. We have the category over here. So the more number of projects you will be adding, it will get updated over here, like the demo website. And now we have to add these three pages which we have just created on this list. So let's do that. Again, come back to the dashboard, hover appearances, click on menus. And in the pages, select all the three pages, portfolio, contact us, about us page, add to menu. And here you have all the different pages. Fine. Now click on save menu. Again, come back to our website. Let's go to the home page. And here we have the different pages. As you can see, these are the different sections, and this is a page. When we click on contact us page, we'll be redirected to the contact us page. Fine. Now we have to do some basic changes. So just hover here, click on Theme Customizer. Now click on General Setting, Site Identity, and as I said, you can do these changes later. Site title, you can change the site title from here, you can change your tagline from here, and you can also, you know, put in a site icon. What is a site icon? Go to my website, and here at the top you'll see a small icon over here. On Google's website you will see a small icon over here. These are the site icons, so make sure you have your own, and the recommended size is 512 by 512. Fine. So after you do that, you can click on save and publish over here. I'm not making any change, so I'm not getting that option. And now to change the logo from here, come back to your site, click on TV. Here is the logo. From here also you can change the five icon. This is the five icon, as I told you. You can upload your logo and the changes will be done over here. So this is how we change the logo and five icon. And with this, we have successfully completed this tutorial. I hope you guys like this tutorial. This was an amazing tutorial. Make sure you use DB theme and you use blogtoot.com/DB for your theme purchase. And if you guys like this video, make sure you subscribe to my channel. Give a thumbs up to this video and also watch other videos. My other videos like e-commerce video, social network site video. Those are also very helpful. Thank you for watching this video. Take care.